Hello friends, there is a good news that in India we are heading towards the normalcy, but it's still in many parts of the country there are lockdowns and the people have been suffering badly, particularly the businessmen and some local shopkeepers. They have been suffering because of this lockdown, the good thing is that the peak of COVID has been achieved in the month of April and May. The April and May month was very worrisome and difficult for we Indian peoples, but we fought well. We did an exemplary work regarding the infrastructure. As per the population of the country is concerned, here we have almost 1.4 billion people residing in this country, and it is very difficult for any government to manage effectively. But in spite of all these hurdles, we have been able to inoculate almost 22 crores doses of vaccines in our country effectively. And our health infrastructure has been doing very good. So it is a good news for all of us. And now we have enough beds in our hospitals, and the cases are on the declining patterns. My dear friends, I would like to suggest a few things. That last year we adopted many things to just contain this virus, to check the spread of this virus in our community. But unfortunately, after passing of one year, this again we suffered a lot about this difficult disease. The protocols have been changed a little bit. There have been many drugs which were tried in the past, but now we are much clearer in some aspect, in almost each and every aspect of this disease. As you may be aware that the SARS-CoV-2, it is a now the WHO has said that this is an airborne disease and it is in the air. So it is our duty to just contain this virus further, to spread and in the community, and it is our primary aim to spare the majority of the population, particularly our younger and the children. So the protocols of the government that are necessary, we have been following. So I would like to advise the people of my country to please follow the guidelines just put forward by our regulatory bodies. And now even I have been using the double mask in the OPD setup. This is my room, so I have just uncovered my face, but I use the two masks in the hospital setup. One is surgical mask, that is 3-ply mask, and that is second is the N95 mask. So I have been using these two masks for just seeing the patients over here. I would also like to you people to please cover your face with a specific mask, preferably the 3-ply mask. So it is an only thing, because being an airborne infection, it is our primary aim to just get the virus inside our body. But the virus is a normal part of this atmosphere. We need not to worry about that. It may be because there are several infections, several bacteria, several viruses there in the environment. So we need not to be just afraid of these viruses. Let them be inside our body. So what we have to do? We have to keep ourselves, our health in a good conditions. The persons with comorbidities like diabetes mellitus, like hypertension, and the people who have been taking the immunosuppressants, they must be careful and just to avoid coming out in the open. just keep confined to their houses, their homes, and just try to avoid coming out of the house. The rest of the people who are in essential services, like the medical professionals, the frontline workers, and other social workers, they should take care of all measures that are explained by the government agencies time to time. The first thing is to wear the mask on our body, on the mouth and nose. And one more important thing that some people ask and some patients ask, whether we have certain things to just check this virus, to contain this virus in the in our pharynx, means nose and mouth. So whether we should take any natural remedy or anything. See, there are enough evidences and many papers have been published regarding the use of certain things that we can use as a precautionary measures. Some people have suggested and published the papers in this regard that the use of cloth in the mouth, just for just keep the cloth in our mouth, is a good viroprotective. Second thing, enough work have been done on the efficacy of the Tenospora cardifolia, means the giloy, as well as the Indian gooseberry, amla, and the lemon, because all of the food or fruits that are rich in the vitamin C, they may be helpful in containing the viruses. So take abundance of healthy and nourishing food, plenty of vitamin C. There is no need to take the tablets of the vitamin C. Instead, you can take the natural sources of vitamin C, like the lemon and the Indian gooseberry, as well as the Tenospora cardifolia or giloy. So just prepare a warm, lukewarm water. Just boil all these three things in the water and just drink this lukewarm water for the better health. Because in India we have a good immunity. Because we face the many infections, many airborne infections in our country. So our immunity is a good. We possess the good immunity. So the need of the hour is that just keep your healthy lifestyle, do enough exercises, and just enjoy. The people who are in the lockdown in their houses, just do some effective and positive thinking, just do their exercises and spend the quality time with the family. The rest of the thing that we, the healthcare workers and frontline workers, they should take care of their body, keep their stresses very low, and just have the nourishing food, have the plenty of vitamin C in their body. Now, just I am just mentioning a few important things that some people have asked, that if this coronavirus infection is lethal. No, it is a normal flu-like virus, but the problem lies when it just enters into the lungs. Means this is known as the pulmonary phase, because first the virus enters into the mouth, nose and mouth, stay over there, and some people may experience the loss of smell and loss of taste. That is good if they don't have any other symptoms. So it means that the virus is limited to that particular area. Sometimes it goes into the GIT and causes the diarrhea. That is also good, because in that way the toxicity level is reduced, in my opinion. The most problematic phase is the pulmonary phase, when the virus just enters into the lungs. But in majority of the people, even still remains to the milder to moderate form. If it causes the pneumonia, then it is a severe condition. So fortunately, the majority of the people in this second phase, they opted for the CT, HRCT. And the score there predicted the outcome of this illness. So the most important thing, that as soon as you get the symptoms, just keep yourself in contact with a qualified physician. Without consulting a qualified physician, you should not take any medications from the medical store or over the counter. The over-the-counter purchase of the medicine and just taking by just seeing or their indications in the net or on the social media, because in the social media there are various misinformations. There are informations, there are professionals who have been giving the good informations, but as per the medications is concerned, either it is the traditional medicine or it is the Western medicine, whatever, any medicine whatsoever should be taken under the guidance of a qualified physician. Just take my words for it. Don't consume any medication without the advice of a physician. And just see your vitals. Tell all these vitals to your physician. If you suspect that there is the need of the hospital admission, then go for the hospital, choose for the hospital admission, but strictly under the guidance of the physician. The majority of the patients, say 80% of the patient, they don't need to visit the hospital. Majority of the patients, they have been managing themselves under the guidance of only the 15 to 20% of the patients, they just need the indoor cares. And as for the death rate is concerned, it is still at the 1 to 2% in our country. So we did well, but obviously precious lives have been lost. This is very unfortunate on the part of a country where we have been developing our medical infrastructures with leaps and bounds, but still in this wave of the coronavirus, our medical system got exhausted. But still we did well with the situation, and we contained this virus. I hope that with the proper guidelines and with the proper and